I had to get out of Hollywood. Get back to the trenches. They said they need me. Yo, what's good, guys? It's your boy Hollywood Man. Hey, and we coming at you with another video, bro. That's right, I'm back and here to stay, man. This year I am grinding for top rep, and I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys what I believe to be the best big man build in the game. But before I do that, go ahead, hit that sub button, hit that like button, and drop a comment down below with what your overall is right now. I want to know, and I also want to know your guys' build so I can add you guys and play with you guys. It's your boy Hollywood. So I'm also gonna go ahead and drop my Twitch link, which I'm gonna show you guys gameplay after I show you the build of the build from my stream last night. If you guys weren't in my stream, I was literally scoring like 16 points a game with this build. This build is just too dominant, I promise you. So we're gonna go ahead and start with power forward. So I'm gonna walk you guys through why I go power forward instead of center. Well, first of all, the speed. So on a center, you get anywhere from 31 to 34 speed this year. On a power forward, you have the ability to start with 60 speed. That's insane. On top of that, with this specific build, which is a post-scoring shot creator, I get Difficult Shots Hall of Fame, which on center, you don't get that. So you get an extra Hall of Fame badge, and then you're also going to get an extra silver badge. And along with those wonderful badges, you also get 10 times better shooting stats. My three ball, I think it starts off at a 63 on a center, and on this, I believe it starts off at a 68, guys. And if you guys, like I said, if you've watched my stream, a 68 three ball, that's basically a 70, and you'll see with my wingspan, I actually drop it down so it becomes a 70. It makes a huge difference. I can green consistently, guys. I was going 4 for 5 from three consistently, like every single game. So with the weight, this is a very tricky thing because you really want to pay attention here to your lateral quickness and your strength. So you have to find a really good mixture. I played with this a lot last night, and my buddy Breeze actually helped me find this. He's a phenomenal 2K player, but I ended up going ahead and going with 267 because I get 90 strength and 55 lateral quickness. Now see, if I go max weight, I'm only gonna gain 1 strength and I'm actually gonna lose 2 lateral quickness. So if you drop it down to 267, it's a 2-to-1 ratio, so much better than the other method. Obviously, you don't wanna go max weight, go 267, guys. I promise you, you will not regret it. This build is insane. Next, we're gonna talk about wingspan. Now wingspan is huge this year, guys. If you guys go max wingspan, you are going to regret it. You take a huge hit on your shooting percentages and your shooting rating for literally, it's just literally so bad. It's terrible. I can't tell you enough, do not go max wingspan this year. I'll just show you right now. If you go max wingspan, you're moving shot 3, 61. Okay, don't worry about that. But look at your open shot, 64 open shot 3, bro. That means with your boost, you aren't even gonna hit 70. On top of that, your open shot mid is a 68. So you're gonna have a 73 mid with boosts. That is terrible, absolutely terrible. Now, if you go default, you're gonna come out with a 73 midi, which, okay, that's fine. With boost, you're probably gonna be about a 78. And an open shot 3 of 68, so with boost you're gonna be about a 73. Everybody knows this year shot contesting has to do with basically jumping or putting your hands up. Your shot contest rating really isn't gonna affect it that much. So what I decided to do was, I know I want to get that three ball to a 70 off rip, or at least as a max. So when I boost it, I get a 75. I know I can consistently hit with that, so I went ahead and dropped it 2, guys. Just 2, don't go any farther than 2. That's gonna give you an open shot 3 of 69, which boosts to about a 74, and an open shot mid of 75, which is gonna give me basically 80, guys. That is phenomenal. And then on top of that, I'm gonna get an 82 standing dunk with a 91 post fade, post hook, and post control, along with an 80 box out, a 60 speed, guys. On a center with the same build, you get 31 speed. Make a power forward this year, along with a 90 strength. I can bang with any big man in the game with that 90 strength. I think the max strength strength you can get on the post scoring shot creator on the center is a 93. It's three difference, bro. That's not gonna hurt you at all in game. I definitely recommend dropping it to guys. The one with Joel Embiid, you can't miss it. Pretty simple. If you go all the way down, it's really not that much better. You gain 2+3 ball for T-Rex arms. So I wouldn't even take the time to look at that. Go ahead and go with Joel Embiid's arm length, 88.6 inches. Now, last but not least, make sure you guys follow my Twitch. I'm gonna be live more than likely after this video drops. Hope you guys enjoyed the video as much as I did making it. It's been your boy Hollywood. Make sure to follow me on Twitter. Hit that sub button. Drop a like. Drop a comment down below, like I said, with your overall and your build so I can add you guys. It's been your boy Hollywood. I will see you guys in the next video. Peace.
Working me. She working me. Urging me. It be urging me. Chill it up. The top of cold, the curtain, please. I decided to go up like Major League.